Now, for a quasi-linear function like u equals to root of x plus y, now for this function, you need to derive the Marshall and Riemann curve. Okay, remember this, that p1, p2 is the price vector, p1 is the price of x and p2 is the price of y respectively. Income is m, that is income of the consumer is m. So, and your budget line is p1x plus p2y equals to m. Fine. So let us form the Lagrange, which is root of x plus y plus lambda m minus p1x minus p2y. Fine. So how many partial derivatives we'll find out? One each for variables and one for constraints. So three partial derivatives we are going to find out. So what is del L by del x? That is 1 upon 2 root x minus p1 lambda is equal to 0. What is del L by del y? That is 1 minus p2 lambda is equal to 0. And what is del L by del lambda, which is m minus p1x minus p2y is equal to 0. Okay, now let's name them. Supposedly this is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. Fine. So dividing one by two. Okay, so what is it that you will be getting? That is 1 upon 2 root x is equal to p1 by p2. Okay, implying further, your 2 root x, if it goes here and this goes here, this goes here, so it becomes p2 by p1, which is root x is equal to p2 by 2 p1, or x is equal to p2 by 2 p1 square. Clear? Now substitute x is equal to p2 by 2 p1 square in 3. Okay, and what is it that you will get? You'll be getting m minus p1. In place of x you will write p2 by 2 p1 square minus p2 y is equal to 0. So simplifying it, you'll be getting m minus p1 into p2 square upon 4 p1 square minus p2y is equal to 0. p1 and p1 will get cancelled out. You will have m minus p2 square upon 4 p1 minus p2y is equal to 0. Okay. Or it is okay, so it is m minus p2 square by 4 p1 is equal to p2y, or m by p2 minus p2 square upon 4 p1 p2 is equal to y. This p2 p2 will get cancelled out, and this will give you y is equal to m by p2 minus p2 by 4 p1. Clear? Well, this is fine, or in case you want to simplify it further, this should give you y is equal to LCM is 4p1 p2. Okay, so this becomes 4mp1 minus p2 square. So this is y. Fine. So your x was p2 upon 2p1 square. P2 upon 2p1 square. And y is 4p1m minus p2 square upon 4p1 p2. Fine. So these are your Machielian demands. But if you see it clearly, so what is it that you will notice? So what is it that you will notice is, well, if 4p1m is greater than p2 square, then y star is positive, which is fine. But even this thing, when y star is greater than or equal to 0, which is fine, but if 4p1m is less than p2 square, then y star is negative. But y star negative is absurd, and hence this would imply that actually in this case y star is equal to 0. Clear? Now if y star would be 0, then entire thing is going to be spanned over x. Okay, so your budget line would be like this, because nothing is going to be bought of y. So your x would be m by p1. So if 4p1m is greater than or equal to p2 square, then these are your Machielian demands. Your x star is equal to p2 upon 2p1 square, and y star is equal to 4p1m minus p2 square upon 4p1 p2. Well, if 4p1m is less than p2 square, then y star would be negative, which is absurd, because negative quantities are not allowed. Hence, y star would be 0. So, substituting y star 0 in the budget equation, will get p1x plus p2 0 is equal to m. So, x star would be m by p1 in that case. Clear? So, this is the case of quasi-linear function. Clear? Thanks.